allow him to go crazy. Tizian's very good in that B-bomb set as well. But we can focus now on Inferno. Ladies and gents, it will be big side in the CT side here. MVP, the plucky underdogs. We want to see more from them, whether they can actually go toe-to-toe with this tactical squad of big. And we'll see next there, actually with three players at that B-bomb site. Tizian trying to bait him in. And we'll see this slow approach from MVP with two smokes, three flashbangs. And this is going to be enough. They've got those PT-50s out again. We saw a lot of those yesterday.
We did see a lot of those. And we also saw a lot of AUGs from Big. They're still sticking to that meta. Tizian will start it off. Gets tagged out through the boards. They'll back it away. Nex is still right beside him. And in the site directly, you've got Legia as well. Tizian's actually got Zeta back. So they've already found two. Inferno, okay, it's picked by MVP. I think you don't win this, you don't win this series. Dust2, okay, I'll give them that. I could see them with the aim and mechanics without getting into team play that the Asian teams often do have. Maybe you get Brawl style and you find some picks, you find some entries, it snowballs for you. But I can't see them winning it on Overpass, to be fair, either, just based on tactics. But see, again, this is a team I think could be surprising. Inferno the first task, and it's already failing quite significantly on the pistol. Tabson's even going to find Zyne on a flank and wrap through mid-wall. It's 1-0.
Even
a little tilted.
Even all the points we discussed, I actually, with this map pool, I think Big have got this quite convincingly. I feel like Inferno, it's a nice tactical slow-paced map. You're not going to be pressured too much. You can use a lot of utility, which is what they're very well-versed in. Now they've got a decent pistol as well, and I really do feel like Dust2, they'll have a solid game plan to let Tabson really go to town. But more than happy to see MVP turn up and see what they can offer. They're going to be certainly bringing everything out here. Zeta has got the Glock, but I assume he had to drop as the scouts are out. The deagles are there as well. Gets a deagle in the end. There it is. As now Legia and Tizian pushing down towards B. Grenade towards T steps. Remember, he had all that utility damage yesterday on Inferno as well. So we'll keep track of that. See if they can break the combo they had of about 900 damage between Legia and God B. Round two here. Plenty of utility left. MVP with a very slow approach. Gob just with the 5-7. Tabson, if you remember, Matt, he had that slow start. His AWP wasn't looking too good on Inferno. It wasn't until he brought out the rifle that it really started to look good. And speaking of which, Legia, he's starting to turn up now. He'll go down eventually, but at least brings it back to a 3v3. Next arrives on the scene of the crime, but he's only got the MP5. We know that's had a few problems the last couple of days, but still 2v3. Next is low, but survives and waits for his teammates to rotate in.
MP5 will rotate back through ruins. Flank is slow. I have to say Gompy's just leaving the A side of the map now. He will still get to the bottom side of Banana and be relevant because that's where Zyne wants to hold from. Flash isn't really necessary, though, because that's actually just going to be a tell. Gives away that he's coming that direction. He's already spotted as well. Now he's locked in toward the logs. It'll keep Zyne preoccupied. And on a scout, it's not like it's easy to hit the shot. Gompy can take him down and will.
Defuse coming in. Zef can. Oh, he can actually deny the defuse here, but not quite. They had to stick on it as well. Tabson is defusing the bomb. He has got it. It is going to be the 2-0. That is the force buy, remember, from MVP. They get the bomb planted. If they'd got another kill, they might be tempted to force buy again. The option's still there, baby. Glills, armor, but not much else. We'll see whether they want to go for it. Like I said, I don't think it's necessarily worth. I can see a scout purchase there. They are going for it, man. Galil's armor and a scout. And there's Legia getting the two very crucial frags. And yeah, like I said, MVP, if they'd got one more kill, I'd be happy with this. But we'll see what they can do for Galil's. Basic utility with three smokes and a couple of flashes. But it is a bit of a surprise play. You wouldn't necessarily expect this if you're the defending team right now. God B, aggressive top and middle with the Orc. Going through their procedures towards B as well, trying to get that full control of the MP9. Need to be careful, and you can hear MVP not spamming the smokes, man. They're not giving anything away. They want to make sure this is a surprise. Until there's a guaranteed kill available, they will just hold up and see if the CTs get a little bit impatient or frag hungry.
Yep. Still holding back. As you'll expect, he won't be necessarily the one on the front lines at all times. But he is beyond Gob, and well, he's going to throw a nade inside the apartments now, but that's going to be his primary function. It looked like he was going to try and flash Gobby back into contention as well. Right now, though, they've got a concern because they've got mid-wall information, but not much else. And I think Legia is going to have to get on the rotation now out of assumption at this point.
Yeah, the Fat Tizian has his smoke, so that's why he's happy to be there by himself for now. But he's only got that MP9, right? He will be pounced on, so he does need a bit of backup here. Playing in front of the smoke for now. Rotation's coming through from Legia, but they've both got SMGs here. If they're going to find equal trades, that's going to be a very tall order. And now the flashbang with Legia, that is not ideal. He wanted to bounce it a little bit higher, but now still a 3-on-3. That's with the scouts. And remember, they won't have much of the post-plant situation here. God B brings it back to the advantage for Big. Throws a grenade around towards Coffins. That's actually pretty decent, but the shot's even better. Zeph finds it. Tabs in and next on the retake now.
We've had the Battle of the Blackwater, the Battle of the Bastards. This event, we're having the Battle of the Coaches.
Exactly.
It doesn't have the same ring to it, but it's Legia's turn to try and
replicate Clash of the Coaches.
Yanko. Clash of the Coaches. Wow.
Yeah.
Just so beautiful. How do you do that? Oh. Nice tag on the next. That'll make it easy for Zeph to pick him up. But reveals his position doesn't even matter. He takes Tapsin in a direct duel.
Yeah, a little bit unfortunate there for Legia. The Splash he was trying to line up a little bit higher, and it bounces off first oranges and lands right in the faces of the tees. But fortunately, just got a face full of the flashbang himself. Managed to wait there for it. To be fair, either way, like they were always going to struggle with that hold. They had an MP5. An MP9 to defend against Skillulz. So MVP, it was a bit of a risk to invest in that round fully, but it has worked out. Big with a slight partial investment here. They're not spending much more than about $1,500 per player. Taps into the Deagle Kevlar. A couple of HEs available as well. Tizian holding that towards the B side of the map as MVP get control of that side.
Off down again toward the barrels and sandbags. Zeph's going to work his way back in. The chance for the AK actually fires out. That reveals his position. He takes a slight scathing shot from it. It doesn't quite do much damage. Puts him on a 63. He'll be happy with that to take down Legia. And the Deagle forced off by smoke won't have much more vision. Boost to the flower pot. That's not unlikely or that surprising, really. The XP and not a Deagle, so it can't even find the long shot. Did give them the information that there's one toward Emo. The bomb's a little bit slow to go down, so they'll get ready to push through ruins. They'll get positioned so that they can try and trade, try and overwhelm, but unfortunately no kits and sure, some armor. Not really likely they'll pull much off from this. If they can get to that Galil, get a trade with a pistol on the way in, maybe even just a straight entry if they can get the shot to Zeta. They might be able to do something with this! I thought Tizian turned around in a panic and hit that. Tapsin got it instead. Can't quite pull the Galil out. Not enough time to get it ready. And HSK shuts them down. That should be the round. Gobby, he's well down toward mid looking for exits.
He absolutely is. Not really much he can do with this one, I'm afraid, though. 5-7 in hand. Even if he gets this first kill, he might not even go any further. He'll probably be traded out. But he knows they're in the corner. Trying to sneak his way through. He has been spotted now. Comes around the corner. Nails the first. Could get the second as well. Does it. $600 in the bag. Gets the AUG as well. That's not a bad finish from the in-game leader. Well done. 4 kills, 1 death for him. And he can actually drop an AUG now. So he's got himself in a fantastic spot. He gives that straight to his star player, Tabson. He'll have the AUG. Smoke. Couple of flashbangs now. Great stuff. 2-2. AUGs out for HSK. We saw some fantastic work for him yesterday. We'll see if he can keep that up.
Op ready for HSK. Doppy with a nade is going to throw that immediately into Banana. Not deep. Without Molotovs, they're expecting perhaps they have taken advantage of that. So shallow nade. Fortunately, doesn't find anyone directly. Still, they're going to push onto this B site. HSK's got the AWP. Tie game and no money, really, on either side because of the fashion of the rounds. Again, Gob B taking 2 down at the end of the last round was fantastic.
This is certainly the weaker side of the map. Legia and Tizian doing their best, and Legia will be dropped with a lovely AK shot. Tizian's got nothing to answer back with.
I thought if he got that kill, he did well. He nearly got caught with the nade out. The fact that he got away with very little damage, he could have used that smoke to his advantage, unfortunately. Just could not get the aim, and MVP is going to have their third round. So now we're starting to see why they picked this map. Now, I say that. It's not like they've done too much tactically. They've been smart about getting the position in Banana, but you're right. They're picking on B right now.
Well, yeah. You've got your kind of Tizian, who's normally the B anchor, but he's certainly not the star player of the squad. He's normally pretty handy for maybe one, two frags per round, but he's not that aim star, like perhaps like a Nex or a Tapson. And you've got Legia, obviously the coach. We've seen his struggles, and he's definitely
the aim star on the team, in theory, should be Zontarez.
Absolutely. That's the problem. You've lost your real heavy hitter there. And that's the point I was making in the pregame. What do you do now? Do you just pick Legia and Zontarez's spot and hope he can pull that one off? Or do you have to move things around completely and change the whole system? I think it has to be the former, because you need everyone else firing all cylinders, doing their usual roles instead of changing everything,
right? The only thing you could change is if you just want to run a Hail Mary on entry T-side and get Legia in a position to throw support nades.
Yeah.
Other than that, CT positions, yeah, you're right. You almost have to leave them identically, because you learn intuition in each position, and you learn subtleties that mean certain things, and therefore rotations and timings and how to play off each other. Without, you would be surprised. We talk about communication, and we harp on communication. A lot of people at home would be surprised, I think, when you hear how there's terrible communication in matchmaking.
Yeah.
You get to a point where you're talking a lot. Then you get to a point where you're talking a lot, but you're communicating clearly. And then you get to a point where communication becomes so good that you actually don't have to say anything at all. You learn to play off each other. So when you play a CT side, you would be surprised at how little conversation there is, and how looking at the radar, knowing the tendencies of the round and where your teammate is, you don't have to say anything, and you know exactly what they're up to.
One thing I will say is Big can actually speak German. With this setup, Zontarez obviously doesn't speak that language. They've been communicating English as of late, and that's one small benefit, I suppose. But they definitely want their star player to come through as we get into the next round. Bit of an odd one. They saved those three rifles, but they did not invest around it. They really are playing this one conservatively. And once again, focusing that B bomb site. Three CTs there. That's going to be Gobby, Legia, and indeed Tizian, holding that with their pistols. It will be Nex, Tabson holding A with the rifles. This could be enough, but MVP have looked solid upon entry on this bomb site, throwing in the grenades to common positions we know they've played before. Execution, that's the Molotov towards the emo position on half wall. You'll see that thrown in momentarily when they're ready for the execution. Stacks should be one throwing it. So here it comes.
The headshot. Get the straight punch. Flash again. Just didn't work out for Legia. Couldn't find the headshot at all. Zef takes him down. All around him, but barely on him as he goes to 83. But Tizian with the deagle. Significant damage. And Gobby's here as well with the AUG. That's going to work out extremely well. Stax and Zyne go down. Just HSK, 41 seconds, and it looks like he's already backing out. AWP in hand. He could rush toward A. He could beat them to the site. I say that. Tabson should have the cutoff. And given the HP, it should be pretty clear who wins that duel.
Well, there we have it. It's a round going in favor of the CTs. They actually send an extra player towards that B bomb site. Legia sent in first. That could have been by design. I'm going to speculate that maybe he didn't buy a single thing with the USP. He was sent in with the flashbang to suggest, boys, just USPs here, come on in. Maybe that's overthinking it, but that would be next level mind games. That's what he went for.
And you beat the guy that they've been exploiting.
Exactly.
So
you
now
him
you
in.
Rotate over Gobby. It's like, oh, we switched it, by
if
the
that's,
way.
That actually will prove. That's their mindset, saying you don't buy a thing, you run out with a USP and say we're full eco, we're waiting with Deagle armor and the Org as well. That could be super smart, but I'm not sure that's the case. But I would love to find out.
Gobby is...
It wouldn't surprise me. Yeah. That's why I'm speculating, but I'm not sure that would be the case. If it is, I would love to know.
We'll have to ask him.
We will.
We'll corner him in the hotel. Going on this elevator, are you?
Press the alarm button. Yeah. Elevator stops.
Shut the door.
Talk about that
down,
USP.
Hit the hold button. So.
Oh, by the way, Matthew, just to give you an A-stream update.
Oh, dear.
Oh, this is not looking good. 15-0 for MIBR in the first half of Nuke.
What? Over Fnatic?
Yup.
They just were in a final in Shanghai like 2.5 weeks ago.
Cold Zero, 21 frags first half.
Dear God. What map?
Nuke. So, CT side star for them.
Obviously. Either way.
Yeah, of course.
New nuke. That should never happen. Holy moly.
The thing is...
So, and they said on the desk they've been practicing it, and MIBR has been saying that they've been practicing it.
I've cast them a lot recently, and their CT side always looks solid. It's their T side that's pretty
Well,
ropey.
The good news is Astralis took time off to practice, so now they can make sure they polish their nuke, because it looks like MIBR is ready to take them on it.
Yeah.
I'm not going to go that far, but it seems like that's their intention.
I think so. We were talking about that earlier, weren't we? Like, none of it's many teams want to play that map. It looks like a few are, as they make their way through the smokes. It's Nex, ready to gun them down, looking for a third here. It's Chaotic. He'll get two and actually burn one from the grave. It's going to be a 4-2 now of HSK and Stax. We'll have to pick up the pieces here. They have got time and a headshot available. That's overextending Tabson, I would say. Got a huge advantage, and now they can make their way towards spawn. And the B side is open for now. It's just Tizian who's all the way at the bottom, so this could actually still go wrong. Tizian will have to make his way back. Legia's locking them in, but he can't really justify going forward either because he hasn't got any idea whether they're actually making their way towards the B bomb side just yet. Tizian comes in, but he's got 50 HP, no smokes, a flash. What is the play here? Maybe get in the cubbyhole and try and defend the plant. We'll see what he can do. They're going through ruins silently. Yeah, that's the best position. I would have played this as well. That's the one to do.
Yeah, let them have CT. Just contain them. Doesn't have a lot of support, though. He is still solo. But he went late. Bomb was already down. If he had caught them searching the site pre-plant or during the plant, he could have
exactly
isolated
right.
It one-on-one.
Risky either way, but yeah, definitely should have tried to deny the plan. Either way, 2-on-2. Kit available for Legia. God be with him. Let's see whether they can get this one done. MVP with the crossfire from Ruins and New Box. Time ticking away. Need to find this quick kill. They'll get the first, but Stax in a great position still. He gets the first kill. Not going to happen. And it will be to Legia to get the defuse and the final kill as well. Great stuff from Big. They keep themselves in it.
HSK saw the shadow and couldn't hit that shot. I don't think he was ready for Gabi to drop.
Yeah, there was a lot going on. And a tactical timeout. A couple of frustrating rounds there. Big allowed the bomb to get planted, but they went out in the 2-on-2. Zion was 0-6, so yet to really make his mark here on Inferno. Another best of three.
All right.
You all right with that?
A sign not to be savage. So, someone grabbed my throat and said, don't say it, and stop me. I was going to say maybe he should resign. And my own anatomy stopped me from a horrible joke, so there you go.
Fair enough. Well,
even my body knew.
Even he knew. Well, it's big.
Oh, no, my body's a she.
Is it really?
I'm a he, but my body's a she.
Makes sense, actually. It'll be Tabson with the AWP. And as I mentioned, he is the main AWP of this squad, but he's actually found a lot more success with the rifles at this event. Obviously, the team's plugging holes all over the place, and maybe he feels like this is the right time to bring it out. He had a good spawn as well. He might challenge second middle. Could just go forwards T-steps. We'll see which way he's inclined. Gonna check that T-steps area. They're rushing B. So they're gonna be ready for this. This B bombsite has been bullied, like we said, but good grenade so far.
Fantastic grenade. The follow-up as well. There was two there. That wasn't all one. Was it? I don't think so. I think there must have been the second one thrown as we switched cameras. Either way, Tizian gets the damage done. Legia gets a ton of damage inflicted. And I want to check and see, again, the utility damage. I can't find my mouse on the screen.
Click.
It's, oh yeah, you're right. It's my first day on the job. Where is he? Legia.
You were there.
I was there.
133.
Oh, thank you. Right, UD. I was looking at EF. So he's the highest. Oh, no, he's not. So Tizian's higher at 167. Either way, 133. By the way, MVP, to give you a comparison, they have 35 total.
Yeah.
Not ideal. It is a little bit easier to funnel banana on the CT side, but still, you should be able to do something to counter it. So anyway, how's you?
I just want to hang out while we watch this. casual broadcast. Legia on the AWP. We talked about this yesterday. I'm glad they made this change. We were talking about it. It's like, Legia, you don't have to be as fresh or as crispy to use the AWP. You can hold angles and be smart. He's been an AWP historically as well. Yeah, right. You don't need to necessarily DM to hold angles to the AWP. And if you can get positions and play smart, that could be enough. I think that's a really smart call. Tabson, that's great as well. Gets the first. HSK going down. And now it's a 5-on-4 in favor of the Germans. We'll see if they can hold them off here. Smoked out for now. MVP will try and reclaim territory. Be holding towards the apartments. It all comes to a bit of a standstill here. We have got a few smokes remaining on the T side, but Legia and Tizian have a great little setup here. I love this. You can see Tizian's tucked in the corner with the AWP right next to him as well. So that could be a lovely bait and switch. Hopefully we'll get to see that come through as they smoke towards middle. I don't see many openings for MVP here. They got two towards the end of the apartments, but solid hold from the CT forces, although there's only two CTs at the quad side.
Off by a miss. Bobby goes down. They got two. Somehow Tabson's still alive in this. Ooh, it's a battle of the ops. It's whoever doesn't miss that will win it. Tabson seemingly beats Zeta to it. And we go 6-3 for Big. MVP's still in this. They're still.
Fnatic is still
kicking away. No, they're not.
Oh, it's just gone. Okay, 6-over. 16-4 finishes. They just
closed
it out.
If they pull that back, that's just silly.
Well, that's that map out of the way. They got Overpass next. Just
wow.
So you know.
That's a good MIBR map as well.
Fnatic pick Nuke as well. They just got 15-0 on their map pick.
Oh, dear.
Damn.
Oh, Exist. I'm sorry. Oh, Yumpy.
Yumpy.
He won't have any Yump left in his step.
Well, Tabs in, mate. He wants to still, of course, perform as much as he possibly can. An absolute unit in CSGO. Such a strong player. On his day, hopefully we get to see him at his best. 6-3 up right now. Up against an eco as well. Double orb setup. Really like that. You can see the gear. Just gets himself in a prime spot. He has been left alone, but that's fine. He's up against those deagles. If he gets one deag here, that could be the round. It's unlikely, but we'll see how he fares. As soon as they confirm it's just pistols, someone should be falling back to help him out because it could be a little bit too scary for him. We'll see. Holding the angle right now. There are players on towards that T-steps as well. Needs to be careful. They're starting to rotate in. One kill, fall back. That would be more than enough.
Yeah, I completely agree with that. He does not need to be a hero. Does fire into the flash. That's not unsurprising. He's got one. Stays with the pistol, interestingly enough. He could have even at least tried to repeat with the AWP at that range, but you're right. It was too much. Get back. Jump away. Bait them in. He still has led them toward Tizian, and they try to overrun him. They will. He gets two with an AUG. That's not expected, or excuse me, unexpected against pistols. They now have the AWP and the AUG that they took down on entry. Look at this. Just pull out the knives and start swinging. Someone's going to win that exchange. And it will be Tabson and Nex, who push through on the back of a flash thrown by Godby.
Excellent work. There it is. No harm, no foul. I don't think they recovered the secondary orb, though, so that has gone. Will they repurchase it?
Tizian could easily drop it. Tabson could buy a second one easily. I don't think it's required, though, is it? Nex has 10K, but when's he ever gone to a secondary op?
Well, it's round 11. Big 7, MVP 3. AKs are out across the board for the Asian squad. And Zion, 1-9 for him. It's big. Start to look very comfortable indeed on their CT campaign. Remember, this is the pick of MVP as well, so I really do want to make sure they win this one. It's Dust 2 next, and like I said, if Tabson gets warmed up, that could be very scary. And actually, Nex is a bit of a beast historically on Dust 2 as well. Holding up. Shots towards the apartments there. And MVP have demonstrated a very slow-paced game the last couple of days here. Worked out for them. They managed to have some very interesting and cool strategies deployed. Inferno now as they make their way through towards the apartments. There is a little bit of presence there. Nex with the AUG at the end. And a two-man stack towards Arch. That's going to be Legia and Godby. The old duo.
Balcony next, counter incendiary.
He's done really well with that incendiary.
He has, and he's also found Zion, who I believe just went straight through it because they haven't gone mid wall. There's still two over toward the arch, so he tried to run it. I think he heard the tag as well from the first one. Next certainly had to have heard HSK dropping down. He will now because he's firing in. Does he find a gap in the smoke? Either way, the two players in front library will get safety by backing off. Stick around Modo, push through together, get the trade. Legia is able to take stacks, and he follows on HSK. That's not bad. Four kills for Legia.
Yeah, big plays. And just a shout out to Nex. Yeah, it might seem like a small detail, but that incendiary, like, he does a really good job there. He segregates one of the players, makes them fully commit, locks the other two out. And I'm not 100% sure, but I'm going to assume they missed that smoke towards the apartments. You ideally want to dribble it onto the hay bales. You can actually see when your flashbang goes through. Instead of being completely gray screened, stuck behind a Molotov, I think they screwed up the smoke, to be honest. But there it is. 8-3. And they are going to buy into this one. Galils, three of those. They've got a lot of faith in that weapon. Fair play. We'll see if it works out. Round 12, and they have three players towards B for Big once again. The grenades coming through. Ton of damage towards Zeta. He'll have to fall back. Lick his wounds and T-spawn.
It's Stax with the AK will hold out. Well, Zion heads toward the boiler. Smoke from Gob be in the doorway, interestingly enough, not out toward mid. But what it does do is exactly that. It protrudes beyond the doorframe. And as it is a rounded figure, it lets him see the feet before they would see him. So it is kind of clever when they walk out middle. Legia, he knows they're dropping into the pit, tries to do a bunch of damage, does reasonable with his attempts because Stax is tagged down to 71 and he got HSK, who I think had some damage inflicted previously, but gets him onto 50 anyway. Dennis still has the only kill in the round, but despite having pit, I don't think there's really much in this. They really need the mid wall to wrap as well, and now they'll get that. Zef gets Gobby. Now they can start to force and pressure Tizian, who has to swing wide, but does. Now he's above, and it's Legia again on rotation. He seems better when he has to relieve himself for the B site and force back into the play, but he's got to be careful. He'll find Zion as well.
Yeah, he's looking strong right now. The turret gets 4 kills before, 3 in this round, getting much better. As we'll see go 9-3 here. And now I think that's got to be an eco with the
kills. He's leading the way now. 7 kills in the last 2 rounds. He's on 13 total.
There it is. What a difference a couple of rounds makes.
Way to go, Legia.
AK-47, they're mixing things up now. I think they're just playing a more versatile game. They're saying, you know what, instead of just saying, you guys are the B players, they're just saying, right, let's see what setups you want to run here. What do people fancy doing? Tabson, you want to go get a kill here? I think they're just playing a looser game, and it seems to be working for them because they've got different setups across the board. We're seeing Legia more on that A site, and maybe that's the key to success here. We'll see the next round come through. Tabson's got the AWP. I don't think MVP can justify much more than some Deagle armor they could go for Galil by again, but running out of time in this first half. Their map pick needs 4 or 5 rounds at least. They have 3, and they've purchased 2 Molotovs with their Glock. And okay, now more is coming in right at the end. They did take a tactical timeout and decided to purchase right this freeze time finish. So they've got P-50s, armor, basic utility, but they are a very slow-paced team. Well, I guess they weren't rushing. Tabson pushing down the CT apps with his AWP. So will he be able to get anything done here? Holding a tight position, not really what you want against CZ's, Matt. Could be a little bit problematic. One missed shot, they could swarm you. Godby's protecting his back, but still, maybe a little bit too up close with the orb, considering they're up against these pistols right now.
Quick flash inside of the smoke. SK has given up the position on that. Gobby goes back around to check boiler. Remember, there's also a push down in the hallway as we're looking at it now. Tabson with an op. Gobby needs to be sure that he's not too far away from the door so we can re-peek it, so we can help his teammate. He needs to be there right now. He's got an HSK, but he was forced out covering top middle instead. So unfortunately, Tabson's left for dead. There's an op picked up, but it's all fine because Gobby's got him rotating back the obvious way that he would go. Gets the op back as well.
You see what I mean? It's like, it's not a big deal, but the fact that there was a chance he could lose that AWP and actually give it to them, when you know a lot of pistols, might want to sort of hold back. But they win the round hands down, so not really a talking point at all. Round 14, and the money's back in favor of MVP. AWP's out again for Tabson, of course, as we get to the closing stages of this first half. AKs in the hands of Godby and Tizium. Tabson's actually bottom fragging. Don't say that too often.
We did yesterday at the start of their match, but that was for
yeah,
4 rounds.
He was 0-8, and he finished on 30 kills.
I think he was 0-6, actually. Maybe it was 8. It might have been that far in. I thought it was... Either way, he
so
was
you
at the start.
You don't know, but you are challenging me, but fair enough. I respect
well, you know, listen, I thought I was right, and now I'm respecting you and saying you could be right, okay?
Okay.
If it was anyone else, they'd be wrong.
Fair enough.
But you're right. It's not common this far into a game that he's still down there. Less so with Legia and the server to go with it. Don't forget, Legia did play for a long period of time, was always teammates with Gobby in that process.
Yeah, even in this particular lineup, actually. And
yep, that's right.
We'll see if it's... Well, he is sort of rolling back the years. He's had 2 fantastic rounds. I have to say the day. He's going to be tested again here, but 3 players there towards B. Gobby maybe overextends the challenge, but Nex is there to take down the bomb. Oh, Legia lines him up. He's looking for another 3K here. He just hides and lets his teammates finish things off. What a half he's having. He's got $16,000. He's got all the kills, and they've got 11-3 on the scoreboard.
Just want to point out as well, when this game was close, they were running Legia down. That's not happening anymore. He's wrecking them, and the game's wide open.
It really is.
Cracked wide open for Big, that is, as it's 11-3. Round 15, end of the half. Buy out, but what can you buy? Mac 10s, 2. UMP, And a Famal, Glil, excuse me, and AK. So one real gun, do you want to call that? They're all real, I get it.
Well, the way they've been using the Glil suggests maybe Stax can find an opening, but Nex is starting to build that confidence now. He's pushed down towards the bottom of middle. They seem to be aware of it, though, but will he be able to find a frag? You better believe he can. There's these two piece towards the T-step. Sign will bring one back with the MAC-10, but surely they can't push that smoke.
Yeah, Nex getting two that far down and surrounded as he was, not likely he was going to get out of there, so it's fine. He's still done the task, done the deed. They'll get the Glil back into Zef's hands. He gets rid of the UMP. You could argue that Zayn should switch over to that UMP. It just has a little more punch. MAC-10's got a little more mobility. Get the push, though. Smoke gone. Tizian didn't need to be there. Flash as well. Whoa! If they had have gotten Gob B sooner than he found two, that could have been it. Zayn's got three kills. We talked about how slow he was in this game to get going. He was 1-9 at a point.
The plays.
That's a call and a half, isn't it?
Yes, he's made a load of noise, smoke spawn, flashed it as well. They don't actually know if he's fallen back
I don't
yet.
Even think that was his call, because he looked committed, and then all of a sudden he just abruptly turned. I'm wondering if a teammate said, you should fake.
Oh, is he going for the oh my goodness, the around the world?
He's making too much noise, though. They're going to hear him before. No, he's heard them. First, this could be an ace. 19 seconds. He doesn't want to stick to it. He wants the bomb to be the play, but he's got to watch library door. He's made it past. Stays in the line of sight, though. That's a call. And I think he was just spotted. So Legia is the man to try and clutch this. Knows the angle. Has the AUG. But the AK knows he's got to walk toward him. It doesn't matter. Legia's going to pull it back. Deny the ace clutch. And get 12-3 for big.
It's the last round. He's having a party. He's enjoying himself. He's throwing the guns around here, ladies and gentlemen. It's got to be 12-3. Legia, top frags with 16 kills. He clutches it out once again. And we're going to a halftime break, Matt. Let's stew over that for a second. We'll be right back.
Tried my best to build up the MVP storyline. This is their map choice, and they just got destroyed. It looked close for a bit, They overran Legia. That apparently just pissed him off and made him a monster. Yeah. He top frags, and it's 12-3 for Big.
He absolutely wrecked them towards the end. Fair play to Legia. We said he was slow yesterday, and he made up for it the utility. He forgot all the grenades today. He's like, you know what? I'm not throwing those for you boys anymore. I'm actually going to get stuck in. I'm going to find the headshots, and he certainly delivered on all fronts. Well played.
As is the case often in scorelines like this, every single player on Big is outfragging every single player on MVP.
Indeed. Good team effort so far. If Big get this pistol, they're going to close this one out nice and early. But MVP were actually pretty handy in the pistols yesterday. We'll see if they can pick this one up. It's going to be two Molotovs, flashbangs, smoke on the Big side. It's about what you expect. They're a very technical team. Love their grenades, love their strategies. There's a two-man stack towards Arch. HSK ready for them. Nails the first headshot. That's going to be Tizian removed, and Tabson trying to pull one back.
Stacks. Good find on Tabson. Hard to hit the backside of a head with a USP in the pistol rounds. Can't quite replicate success against Gobby, who stayed alive for quite a while against Zion, it has to be said. Everyone has a kill that's been damaged. In other words, all the duels have yielded results for MVP. Stacks is dead. He got one before he went down. HSK dead before he went down. He got one as well. Zion picks up two, and Zeta closes it out. Killed his teammate in the process, but he'll pick up the round for MVP.
It was for a worthy cause. Take the teammate.
Charitable
down.
Donation.
The final kill. Indeed. MVP, much needed pistol. Big have the option to force buy or get the AKs in the third. I think it'll be the latter if I know this team. No reason to force buy here. Really don't need this round. You don't have to steal it away. And you can see MVP, they're going to have MP9s, UMPs here. Even if you almost want them to have a clean round. That might sound weird, but you don't actually really want to kill too many of them. You want to keep those lesser weapons and then have a really strong chance of winning it when you have the advantage in the weaponry. As we'll see, round 17 come in. It's going to be the first kill for the CTs, of course. A double nade takes down Tizian. So there we have it. Now we'll be swapping the PT-50 over. Give it to Tabson. Oh, my goodness. They're pushing right down. It's going to be another kill for the CTs here. One of those rounds you don't really care too much about. If there's all the kills happening actually in T-spawn, it suggests it's not really that exciting.
Yeah, that's certainly true. Just hang out down there. Have a chat, maybe have a latte.
Yeah.
We're in Italy, correct, in this map still? Where's it based now? Croatia, isn't it?
I don't know.
I knew this, and now I forget. Someone
I think on a normal day, I would be able to tell you. This, my brain's a little fried
yeah,
today.
Yeah, I feel like I know this too, and I'm just not thinking of it right now. For some reason, I want to say it's Croatia, though. Well, Gobby doesn't really care where it is, because right now, his focus is in the server. And winning the match, simple as that. Good push from HSK. This is the first gun round, and they really want to set the tempo. He's got problems, though, because he's fully surrounded. That smoke down is going to get him away, and a deep smoke to fully allow him to run back up banana. Well played. I have to give them credit on that, because they had Tabson sneaking back out from the underpass that could have easily punished him. But you know what we say to death?
What do we say?
Not today. Zeta. Just peeking with the UMP, did spot Legia just before he faded back through the smoke, so they know there's a presence toward the arch, not much is audibly clear as well. Legia, though, still in good form, entering now on the T side.
Zeph waiting for his chance to pounce. He dodges the bullets in the smoke there towards Arch. Taps in with the apartment's control. Legia watching library. A finish looking likely. We've got Gobby at T steps waiting for any flanks. HSK. He's waiting as well. Bit of a stalemate there right at the bottom. Great shot from Legia. That's a lovely headshot. Takes down Zeph on the bombsite. Gobby loses out on that duel. 3-on-3 still. And remember, MVP came in this with SMGs of masses, so they're quite happy with this situation. They've got two players on the A side. Good crossfire setup.
Stacks still holding it out. Can definitely hear them jumping into the pit. He's aware of it. Bomb has been given back, but that means it's in the open. And they're going to surround and pounce on Tabson. Zine in the sight. He may not have won the ace clutch. Despite playing it very cleverly, he does win this one. Not really a clutch, but holds position and gets them number six.
We saw that crossfire yesterday. So deep within the pits and is holding an angle where you don't even think he's going to be there. You'd assume he'd be challenging by this point. And no, absolutely not. Stacks hold strong until they finally commit there. You can see Zion is playing off the aggro he takes from him. A round where Big looked like they found enough access, but this could go the full distance now. Big wanted to close this out nice and early, but where's the fun in that? Might as well make it entertaining. HSK will get the first kill. They've got a bit of a partial buy here with Deagle. Sizzion taking a lot of damage from the utility, and Zyne continuing the aggression on the CT side here. Looks to be a clean sweep from the CTs, and indeed it is. All five players stay alive, right, and HSK delivering the pain with the AWP.
The speed and conviction to these rounds for MVP. We've got a little bit of a game right
it's
now.
It's a little bit old school, like early CSGO. You'd see teams like NIP whenever they know that opposition's on an eco. They're rushing down, they're getting stuck in.
Charger don't even let you style.
Yeah, you just don't even let them think about it. You got Freiburg rushing Banana, getting four kills on MP9, getting stuck in, and just kind of really tilts you if you're just having a nice little eco, you know, just trying to get some one digs.
Incendiary, bottom side of the mid position. Comp is already through, and he's going to nade Molotov rather. Barrels. Mid smoke, though. Look at Zyne, and look at Zeta. Zeph, it is Zeph. He's through the smokes and Molotovs again. He did burn himself. He did burn himself alive yesterday.
He doesn't
Inferno.
Care.
Look at him go. Utility doesn't. Man, forget Stewie. Forget anyone that pushes smokes ridiculously. Flamey, anyone else you can name. He's just like relentless. Even Zyne's back inside. They burned themselves alive after doing it four rounds in a row last time they played Inferno, and it seems no different. That doesn't slow them down. This is just part of their plan. Unfortunately, it's not the best plan because they gave up A in the process.
Yeah, it hasn't gone well, but HSK maybe get a kill here. My goodness. How he's got the presence of mind to find that kill.
If he had to realize as well, that's the bomb.
It is.
He didn't see it because he got the player after he jumped across, so he didn't actually see the animation of it dropping. So they'll get that back. And he must be thinking, well, where the devil have they gone? He may even think this is B when it's planted because so much time has passed. Yeah, he does. I think he's going to head toward B with the AK. That's almost unfortunate.
Great shot, though.
Played himself here a bit. Okay, he's not even going to go for it, so I guess it doesn't matter where he thinks it is.
Well, he gets himself an AWP. Decent utility as well. Money strong on the CT side, but big find there first of the second half. Taps him with two. Ligia, nice shot on the AK as well. He'll be next, who's on the hunt. Got the Bloodlust, trying to find that final kill. Round confirmed. Big on the MVP map pick. Remember, it's Dust 2 next. That's going to be one hell of a game. The skill and aggression we've seen on the CT side from MVP, which is kind of funny considering what a slow-paced game they played on the T side, is going to be exciting in a map like Dust 2. Like, these sort of players, it's, look how fast that is. Well played. Round 21, and MVP might want to take a timeout here. We'll see if they're that way inclined. It's getting to that point. But no, straight into the action we go. Orgs are out. HSK back on the AWP. Smokes flashes towards the top of B from Big here.
Yeah. Stairs. HSK blind. Couldn't get the shot in. Thought he might give a re-peek a try, given that they're down the hallway. It's a corridor. It's narrow. And then you jump out desperately and bait them to stacks, but he doesn't want to risk it. He'll just go back early and smoke down. Execution potential. A cleared cubby as well on Arch side. Zyne will counter-flash that. The Molotov goes both way in that situation, so although the smoke now changes it, Gobby was not too concerned about anyone pushing against him. Although, if Zeta and Zyne are there, they might. You never know. Just run through everything. Why not? Or Zeph, really, for that matter. HSK does work his way back around, having made that contact inside of the apartments, and he'll find taps in top mid. So Tizian, smoke still down in the apartments, backs off. Good use of utility so far from MVP to buy themselves some space, but there's 50 seconds left, and they don't have a lot left. Zeph has a smoke, and he's on B. That's why he's on B alone. Said, fortunate there's going to be four players on A. And not a bad position from Stax. He is wide now. He is wide now, but still finds kills. Nearly got Tizian dropping into his crosshair as well. HSK now has the information, and Zyne has not yet been spotted in the corner, which should mean success for him. Not if Nex gets to be slow and steady and tapping away on these headshots.
He's got a chance here. A slim one, but there's something there. There's the first shot. Can slow it down now. And it's a one versus one. Zeph waits towards the quad. My God, next. That is absolutely wonderful. I have no idea how he pulls that one off, but it's an absolutely epic performance. 3 versus 1, and he makes it look very easy indeed. You ever seen anything like it?
It was just so precise, so patient on every shot. I don't think Zyne had to force that. I don't think you would have anticipated him to be on that box either way. But nonetheless, clutches are part of it. Mistakes are part of clutches. And he just pulled off a brilliant one.
He's rolling back the years there.
Well, puts them on 14. And it definitely takes the wind out of MVP's sails, which they were starting to feel and starting to roll with. Down to very limited weaponry, certainly for Zeph. He'll play on a CZ on B. And he's got HSK with an AWP. He's at the arch. I thought he was actually the one at the top mid. I was going to say holding him inside of Banana. He's not. It's the only one over now. Zeta, that's going to get overrun. The op does get back to CT, but smokes. Oh, gap. I'm surprised he doesn't want to hold that gap. I was going to say, if they go, he might be able to do something with it. Instead, he puts himself toward ruins. Is he going to push the drop? That's a risky call. Because money's going to be gone, and they're going to be on map point.
Yeah, you're right. I guess they had to make some sort of a play. That's round completely guaranteed now. Stax can't even justify going for this one. He has got no kit. And they're on the hunt. They want to take him down here. They want to leave him with absolutely nothing. They need to be careful he doesn't sneak through, but he's got no intention of doing that. He currently sits in the A pit. My goodness, that clutch on next, that's one of the best we've casted, at least. We haven't seen all the other games, but this tournament, that's got to be one of the tastiest clutches yet. Very, very good stuff. And that's pretty much the round that won in the game, if I'm honest. They haven't got there quite yet, but 15-7 scoreline and the money's completely wrecked on the CT side. It's good as done. And on their map pick as well, Dust2 coming forward. I'm going to check in on the A-stream for you, Matt. I know it's on your mind.
It's definitely been bugging me. I won't lie. I thought a lot about it last night falling asleep.
I don't think they've started the second map yet. Maybe they're waiting for us. They're being polite. We'll finish this one and then they'll get going.
Courteous.
Oh,
we're almost
done.
No,
this completely
one.
Wrong. MIBR up 5-0. Maybe about to 16-0 them again. So.
What was 15-0 and 16-4?
Yeah, you know what I mean.
Not really, because what you meant and what you said were two very different things. Well, incendiary down. Yeah, I think we're almost done on this one, too. Because, again, not a lot of weapons left. Stax at least has the AK that he managed to pick up. He was almost taken down at the end of the last round, spotted in the small pit, but in air inaccuracy meant that he couldn't be shot before the time expired. Again, mass aggression on Banana. Zeph, he's at the logs. Gobby clears the right side. That's done. Doesn't keep eyes on it, peculiarly enough, though. If he had, then they could just clear the logs on the next entrance. Another deep smoke, though. MVP are going to be certainly feeling it because, again, this is their round choice. There's the second one. Clear the right. Next time in, clear the left. And Zeph gets taken down. They knew what they were doing. They knew he was going to be aggressive. Didn't know HSK was going to be, though. And he's got an AK on the ground. Picked up from a CZ. Manages to get behind the stairs as well. That's going to give him some space to work with. He hasn't switched to that AK because he hasn't had the time. Now he does. Flash in. Didn't even matter. He manages to take down taps in. The response is swift, however. And Zeta is left in a one-on-three. Give you the final thoughts on Legia. He still sits at the top tied with Nex on 19. Nex just passes him on the final kill. Both had their moments. Nex had a fantastic clutch, and it's 16-7 in the end for Big.
Yep,